Hello and welcome to this session in which we would look at performance measurement. Before we discuss performance measurement, we have to understand that the company might break down for internal performance valuation its centers or its divisions by four different categories: revenues, cost, profit, and investments. Before we discuss those four divisions, I would like to remind you that if you are an accounting student or a CPA candidate, because this topic is covered in cost accounting, managerial accounting, as well as the CPA exam, especially if you are taking the CPA exam, I strongly suggest you check out my website, farhatlectures.com. I do not replace your Becker, your Roger, your Gleim, or your Wiley. So if you're taking a CPA course, good for you. You need to take a CPA course. I can be a useful addition. I can add 10 to 15 points to your CPA exam. My question to you, are you willing to take that chance by subscribing for a month just to find out whether that system works for me and can improve my grade? Now, if not for anything, check out your university CPA exam performance. Find out how well, on average, the students graduated from your university do well on the CPA or not as well on the CPA exam. This gives you an idea how rigorous your accounting program. If you're an accounting student, I have plenty of accounting courses. Please connect with me on LinkedIn if you haven't done so, and check out my recommendations on LinkedIn. Many students, after they use my product, they write me a recommendation. Check it out. Please like this recording and share it, especially if it's helping you. It might help other people, and it helps me if you like it. And connect with me on LinkedIn and Facebook. So let's talk about the four different responsibility centers real quick. Okay, the first one is revenue center. What is a revenue center? It's a division that only generates sales and it's not responsible for any costs or expenses. The most classic example of revenue center is a sales division. So you're evaluating, you're saying, okay, yes, this is my sales division and I'm going to evaluate you based on sales. Another division could be cost centers, where they only generate costs and they are not responsible for generating any revenue. That's not how you evaluate them. Those two responsibility centers, they are measured by variance. Basically, there's a budget, there's a goal, and how well did you achieve that goal? Obviously, for revenues, you want to be higher. For costs, you want to be lower. Now, what about if a division or as a center is considered a profit center? Basically, a profit center is considered for both revenues and cost. That's or expenses, so it incur both revenues and expenses. So simply put, we should be very familiar with this idea of revenue minus expenses. Here, the profit center is a goal-oriented center because we are taking revenues minus expenses. When I say center, think of a division, okay? Like the Dunder Mifflin office in Scranton. That could be its own center, profit centers, where they are responsible for revenues, they generate revenues, they sell papers, and they also incur costs. They have employee costs, they have rent costs, taxes, so on and so forth. Now, for external users, this sounds familiar as well, because when you evaluate a company, you want to see how profitable they are. So this should be kind of familiar for us, because at this point, you took financial accounting. But here we are using the profit for internal purposes to reward managers. So the way we compute profit here could be a little bit different. That could be, most likely it's a little bit different than external GAAP. And how do we break down those centers? Well, it could be done by a geography, product line, so on and so forth. Anything that make sense to the company. Remember, this is an internal assessment. This is not for external purposes. Therefore, you don't have to use GAAP. You don't have to use GAAP rules. In other words, consider only the cost which is under the management control. So if the cost is kind of assigned to the company because assigned by the corporate because of GAAP purposes, we don't really use it. In a sense, it's not really assessing the internal performance of that division. Okay, so cost may be under GAAP, but not under the manager's division. Now, in the next session, we would look at investment centers. Investment centers look at revenues, look at cost, but also we're gonna add to it assets. And this will be the next session when we look at investment centers. So what are the advantages and disadvantages for using profit centers? One, it's easy to understand. Again, revenue minus expenses. Now, the way we account for revenues, the way we account for expenses could be a little bit different. Nevertheless, the big picture is the same. And we are looking at the manager's effort and decision in generating revenues and incurring cost. So that's why managers like this, because it's directly related to their effort. And basically, we're assessing the revenues and expenses of that particular division. So, and it's easy for the corporate division to compare the corporate the corporate headquarters to compare divisions because we're looking at revenues and expenses. Now, the disadvantages of this is divisions could be of different sizes, but we can find a solution. We could compute percentages, but nevertheless, they could be of different sizes or in different locations, which will make a difference. Okay, and it does not really, the profit centers does not really evaluate the use of the assets, how well the manager is using the assets, okay? Because it's only looking at revenues and expenses, but how efficient are they in using the assets under their control? So therefore, to evaluate the division, we're gonna be using profitability ratios. And we're gonna be looking at two profitability ratios. One is the gross margin and one is the profit margin. They both have the word margin in them, but we have to understand the difference between gross and profit, or sometimes it's called net profit. So what is the gross margin ratio? Well, you have to know what the gross margin is. The gross margin is sales minus cost of goods sold. So if my total sales is 100, my cost of goods sold is 60, I would say my gross margin is $40. Now notice I said dollars. This is a dollar amount when you compute the gross margin. Now I'm gonna compute the gross margin percentage or the ratio, which I'll take the gross margin, $40, divided by $100, and that's gonna give me, for my example, 40%. And this is the ratios that I am looking at. It shows you how well the managers control cost of goods sold in relationship to sales. Simply put, for this example, for every dollar in sales, we pay 60 pennies in cost of goods sold, and we have 40 cents in profit. Now, why do we use ratios? Because now it's easy to understand to compare one division to the other, and you will see this in a moment when we look at an example. So this tells us how well the managers have control over cost of goods sold. Okay, so notice for the gross margin, other operating costs are ignored. We're only looking at cost of goods sold. So to have more expenses included in the computation, we would look at net profit margin ratio or profit margin ratio. Now, how we measure profit, because this is a profit or net profit. Well, we could measure profit as only operating income, or we can measure profit as net income, which is operating profit minus taxes, which is income after taxes. In some textbook, they use operating income. Some textbook, they use net income. But the concept, net income. The concept is you are looking at the bottom line, how much the company is keeping in every dollar in sales, keeping in profit. Okay, so the way we compute this, it's operating profit divided by sales. Again, how we compute operating profit, we could use those two measures. It's also sometimes called operating profit margin ratio. If you're using operating income, it's better to use operating profit margin ratio. If you're using net income, you would call it net profit margin. So don't get confused with the name. It's some sort of measurement divided by total sales. So income after taxes divided by sales, which is net income. So what is the takeaway from all of this? It's how much are we keeping in profit after accounting for cost of goods sold using the first ratio, which is 40%. And let's keep going with this example. So 100 minus 60 equal to 40. This is the gross profit. And let's assume operating expenses, we have $30. So we are keeping this. These are the operating expenses. Okay, so now we have operating income of $10. Now, if we compute the profit margin ratio, 10 divided by 100 is 10%. It means for this company, for every $100 in sales, we are keeping 10% in profit. Now, let's take a look at an actual example. Not an actual, but, a more comprehensive example. Let's assume we're looking at Dunder Mifflin, and we're comparing their New York division to the Scranton division. And we have sales for every division minus cost of goods sold gives us profit, gross margin. For the New York division, 20 million. For the Scranton, 12 million. Then we have operating expenses, 12 million in New York, 8 million in Scranton. Then we compute operating income, 8 million for New York, 4 million in Scranton. Now, by looking at the numbers, you would say, well, the New York division is doing much better. Their operating income is twice that of Scranton. But let's look a little bit further. We compute the taxes and we get after-tax income. Okay, so looking at operating income, it looks like New York does better. Looking at gross margin also, New York is better. But that's not really a fair comparison. Remember, if you operate in New York, okay, especially in New York City, you have more businesses to sell paper to versus if you are operating in Scranton in Pennsylvania, middle of nowhere, okay? So what we have to compute is, first is the gross margin ratio. How much are we keeping after we deducting our cost? Well, the New York division is keeping 40 cents per every dollar. Scranton division is keeping 60 cents for every dollar. So notice, the Scranton division is doing a better job in controlling their cost of goods sold, okay? Their cost of goods sold, it means it's 40% and 60% profit. In New York, it's the opposite. We have 60% cost and 40% profit. Okay, so notice Scranton is doing a better job. Somehow they are buying supplies from a cheaper place, or somehow they're closer to their suppliers. Somehow it's cheaper. Then we can compute the profit margin ratio, which is taking operating income divided by sales, operating income divided by sales. And what we notice here, New York, they're keeping 16 pennies for every $1 in sales. The Scranton division is keeping 20 cents, one-fifth of every dollar they keep it in sales. Obviously, the Scranton division is doing a better job, but the New York division is definitely larger, and this should make sense if you're operating in New York, especially in New York City. So notice what we did. After we looked at the numbers, we want to know, compare them on the same level. Compare them on the same level, you would use percentages. And this is how we'll be able to reward employees, reward divisions, and everyone is happy. At the end of this recording, I'm gonna invite you again to check out my website, especially if you are an accounting student and CPA candidate. If you are a CPA candidate, look, you're going to invest in your career, and you're gonna invest for the next 30 to 40 years. Take your CPA seriously, don't shortchange yourself. Study hard, good luck, and most importantly, stay safe.